This is a tutorial about the fundamental concept of strings, bytes, and runes in computer systems, especially in Go. To demonstrate the connection between the three, I'm creating a string with a single character. In the next line, I'm just printing the string and its length. %s is the format specifier for strings, d for decimals. As you know, under the hood, each string is actually a concatenation of bytes. Therefore, in Go, you can convert a string directly to a slice of bytes. It's actually pretty common in Go to work with bytes directly. I'm printing the slice of bytes in its binary, decimal, and hexadecimal representation. Next, I'm converting the character to a so-called rune. I'm going to need a special function for that. You will understand why in a moment. The UTF-8 decode rune function converts the first character in a slice of bytes to a rune. It also returns the number of bytes for that rune. Finally, I'm printing the rune using the %c format specifier as well as the decimal and hexadecimal representation of that rune. I'm also printing the number of bytes for the rune. The output looks pretty straightforward. One character, one byte. Also, you can actually see what a rune really is. It is a character represented by a number. The rune type is literally an alias for an int32. However, the decimal number of the character is not selected at random. The mapping is actually the famous Unicode table. The dollar sign is number 36, as easy as that. In Go, you say that a rune represents a Unicode code point. I changed the character to a euro sign. Now it's not quite so straightforward anymore. While it is still true that the euro sign rune is represented by a decimal number, here 8,364, it is not a single byte anymore. This is actually what UTF-8 and the decode rune function are for. UTF-8 is a so-called character encoding scheme for Unicode. It's not in the scope of this tutorial, but it defines rules how bytes are structured to represent characters. Also note that the len function of the string now returns 3. It is a widespread misunderstanding that the len function tells you how many characters are in a string. That's not true. Instead, it returns the number of bytes. Next, I'm using a so-called Unicode codepoint escape sequence to write the euro sign. It is basically nothing more than the hexadecimal representation of the rune value. The hexadecimal representation is the same as 8,364 as a decimal value. Please consider liking or subscribing if you want to support the channel. There is one more thing that I want to mention in order to stress the point that a rune is nothing more than a number or Unicode code point. As you can see, you can define a rune directly as a number and print it like before. In addition to this, you can use single quotes to define single characters as runes.